Our most saddening and sobering finding is the total disregard for the safety and welfare of Sandusky's child victims by the most senior leaders at Penn State. The most powerful men at Penn State failed to take any steps for 14 years to protect the children who Sandusky victimized. Mr. Spanier, Schultz, Paterno, and Curley never demonstrated, through actions or words, any concern for the safety and well-being of Sandusky's victims until after Sandusky's arrest. Mr. Spanier, Schultz, Paterno, and Curley repeatedly concealed facts relating to Sandusky's child abuse from the authorities, the Board of Trustees, the Penn State community, and the public at large. Although concern to treat the child abuser humanely was expressly stated, no such sentiments were ever expressed by them to Sandusky's victims. The evidence shows that Mr. Paterno was made aware of the 1998 investigation of Sandusky, followed it closely, but failed to take any action, even though Sandusky had been a key member of his coaching staff for about 30 years and had an office just steps away from Mr. Paterno. At the very least, Mr. Paterno could have alerted the entire football staff in order to prevent Sandusky from bringing another child into the Lash building. Mr. Spanier, Schultz, Paterno, and Curley also failed to alert the Board of Trustees about the 1998 investigation or take any other action against Mr. Sandusky. None of them ever spoke to Sandusky about his conduct. In short, nothing was done, and Sandusky was allowed to continue with impunity. We never had the opportunity to talk with Mr. Paterno, but he did say what he told McQuarrie on February 10, 2011, when McQuarrie reported what he saw Sandusky doing in the shower the night before. Quote, "You did what you had to do. It is now my job to figure out what we want to do." What was to figure out here? We also know that he delayed, Mr. Paterno, reporting Sandusky's sexual conduct because Mr. Paterno did not want to, quote, interfere with people's weekend. It is critical that Old Main, the board, and the Penn State community never forget these failures and commit themselves to strengthening an open, compliant, and victim-sensitive environment where everyone has the duty to blow the whistle on anyone who breaks this trust, no matter how powerful or prominent they may appear to be.